Alright, Brokete Yaba Shimi Aosai. Okay, double honesty, apostles of GMS. Honesty, brothers, of pushing this truth and sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth. Okay, back out here to prophesy the downfall of Babylon. Okay, the society as you know it. And, you know, to prophesy the establishment of a more traditional, more holy. Okay, because when the Lord has it to where the 12 tribes of Israel, the Negroes, the Hispanics, Native Americans, scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, when the Lord has it to where they establish the kingdom of Yahweh Shai on the earth, with actually the Lord establishes the kingdom upon the earth, then you're going to have an establishment of righteousness. Okay, in fact, that will be a good place to start with. And then we go into different topics, different events that are happening out here within the geopolitical stratosphere, if you will. Okay, get into a lot of different topics, man, because there's a lot of things happening right now. Okay, the thing out there with Syria, the thing out there with North Korea, which that's a bit of a false pretense, that whole thing. But, you know, we get into it. We'll all get into it. Okay, let's start off within the book of Amos, the 9th chapter. And I want to go to the 9th verse, okay, because we're in a time where, and that ties in nicely with the article that I got prepared, which I'm getting to in a second, okay. But we're in a time when the Lord's got it to where there's a vast, okay, emptiness, all right, that's out there, with the, especially between the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, okay, because we know through the scriptures that these are going to be the individuals to where with. Like the scripture says, they're gonna have a zeal for the Most High, but not according to knowledge. Now, what does that mean to say? Okay, if they have a zeal for the Most High, then they're gonna see these different things that are happening throughout the four corners of the earth. Okay, and they're gonna try to understand what's going on out here. Okay, that's why the scripture goes as far as saying knowledge, wisdom, and understanding was gonna be the stability of that time, because the questions are gonna be asked, and whether you have that knowledge, wisdom, or understanding was gonna define whether you're gonna be able to stand sturdy or you was gonna be able to stand on the contrawise on the unsteady foundation. Okay, so let's go into this right here. This is in the book of Amos, the 9th chapter, and I'll go to the 9th verse. Okay, and I might go to the Ezekiel, the 9th chapter, and the fourth verse to elaborate on that point. Okay, there's a bunch of questions being asked. Okay, by all of these different individuals, whether they be Israelites, whether they be heathens. Okay, as what's gonna happen with all of these different factors that are about to play major impact on all of these different people's lives. Whether we're talking about the economy, whether we're talking about the different world, wars that are being fought on different fronts. Okay, whether you're talking about the all-out increase in wickedness. Okay, all of those things, people are asking questions about it. Okay, and you was gonna get the answers about all of those different things from the men of the Lord, like it says within the book of Proverbs, the first chapter, around about the 21st verse, how that wisdom was gonna cry without. She was gonna utter her voice in the streets, in the chief places of concourse. Okay, so you was gonna have it to where there was a certain particular group of men that the Lord was gonna have go out there to give you the answers of what's happening out there. Now, whether you was gonna receive it, because the scripture does go on to say how that you was gonna, there's a time of reproval. Okay, you're gonna get reproved because you've been going in a way that if you don't know the laws, how are you gonna conduct yourself accordingly? Okay, so the same thing goes for any individual that will sign in a crime for all the abominations that were done in the midst there, or if they was asking for the different questions as they're gonna be asking right now, man. Okay, they was gonna be asking about what's going on out here, what's going on out here within Babylon. Okay, what's gonna be the end result of this? What's gonna be the end all be all of all of these things that are happening out here? And then they was going to get the reproval, but once they received the reproval, then they was going to get the understanding of the scriptures, and they was going to have their foundations rooted and booted in Yahweh Shai, so they can withstand the time of Jacob's trouble that's around the corner, okay? So let's go into the book of Amos, the 9th chapter, and this is going to be within the, I'll start from the 8th verse. I might as well start from the 8th verse. So it's Amos 9 and 8. It says, behold, the eyes of the Lord power upon the sinful kingdom. Now, we got to stop there and understand that we're living in the most wicked, most heinous time period ever that's ever existed within the entire existence of life. Okay? We know that when the scripture says that when the righteous are in authority, the people's going to rejoice. Right, so if you was going to do the mental mathematics for yourself to understand whether you're in a wicked kingdom, all you have to ask yourself is, are the people rejoicing or are the people mourning? And when you understand that the people are mourning by way of cancers, by way of all of the death, destruction that's happening all over the place, by way of Esau expanding his military all the way to these different borders, then you was going to know that you was in a time where the wicked were in rulership. Okay? Now let's go into that a little bit deeper, and then we go into the scriptures. We carry on within the book of Amos, the 9th chapter. So let's start off in the book of Maccabees 1, okay? And I'll go straight to the point, which is the 20th verse. But rather the 7th verse, and this is dealing with the establishment of the wicked kingdom, okay? Because when you go into the history, when we go into the prophecies, what you get into finding out is that the Most High established four diverse beasts from one another, okay? And all of those beasts represented a particular rulership of a group of people. Okay, so you had the Assyrians, the Babylonians, okay, the Medo-Persians, and then you had the Greeks, and then the Greeks turned into the Romans, and then you had the resurgence of the Roman Empire. Okay, between the resurgence of the Roman Empire and the Greco-Roman Empire, you had the Byzantine Empire, which was a kingdom ruled by the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, what the people call today the Dark Ages. Okay, so let's go on with this ramble. Okay, so when you had it to where the Medo-Persians were taken down by Alexander the so-called Great, by where the spirit jumped on him to go up against a million-man army, and he took down Darius the Mede. Okay, what did he have? Which was, there was a few Darius the Mede, but the last Darius the Mede, after the two battles that they had, the Battle of Issus, the Battle of Granicus, okay, of Granicus, or something or other, okay, when he had taken down that individual, the Most High had it to where he established his throne on his dominion, okay, and that was the first dominion of the whole entire world, okay, the first dominion, okay, of Edom, okay, that's the first dominion where the first time they had rulership upon the whole face of the planet. But let's see what the scripture says as pertaining to that. Okay, so the book of Maccabees, the first chapter and the 7th verse says, "So Alexander reigned 12 years, and then he died, and his servants bare rule everyone in his place, and after his death, they all put crowns upon themselves." Okay, so when you're dealing with four generals, Cassander, Ptolemy, Antiochus, and Seleucus, okay, those are the four, there was really five, and then you had a switch over, or one person was swapped over, I forget the ins and outs of that story, okay? So you had it to where those four generals, they inherited what was the kingdom that Alexandra had amassed to himself, okay? So what they was going to do was they was going to divide those four kingdoms between the four of them, and predominantly, right, or rather more the two significant individuals that come out of that was the Ptolemies, okay, which was ruling out there within Egypt, and then you had it to where you had the Seleucid Empire, which was ruling out there within Syria, okay, in places like, I believe it was Syria, and you had it to where Antiochus, I think he came out of Iran or something like that, okay, but they was ruling around about that region, okay. Now what they was doing is, they was going about Hellenizing the whole world. You read about that within the book of Maccabees, how they had the battles between the Hasmonean dynasties, or the house of the Maccabees, and they was constant back and forth and trying to Hellenize the whole kingdom of Judea. That's where you get the thing of the Gentiles, but that's a different story for a different day. The point we're seeing here is the fact that when these people went into rulership, and you're going to see that within the scriptures, and the dynasty that they set up after them was the kingdom of wickedness, and the scripture's going to say that, okay? So Maccabees, the first chapter, and this is the this is the 9th verse. It says, "And after their death, they all put crowns upon themselves, okay? And so did their sons many years after them, and evils were multiplied within the earth." So after this dynasty was set up of these four individuals, okay, and their sons' sons, etc., up until the Byzantine Empire, you had it to where wickedness increased within the earth, okay? Let's go to the book of Job, the 9th chapter on the 24th verse, okay? This is the book of Job. You know, bread and butter scriptures, okay? But it's all needful information right now, where you got all of these things popping up upon the face of the earth, okay? It's good to have your foundation set for. So this is the book of Job, the 9th chapter, and the 24th verse. It says, "The earth is given into the hand of the wicked." So when you go to the book of Exodus, the 6th chapter, and the 9th verse, it tells you that Jacob is going to be Esau's the end of the world. Okay, so if the earth is being given to the hands of the wicked, okay, and we know that Esau is the end of this time period, then you can come to the conclusion that Esau's going to be the one that's the wicked, okay? So it says here, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked, right? He covereth the faces of the judges thereof, if not, and where, who is, okay? Going to the fact that Esau, okay?
Yeah, you got to ask him where he got him from.
Okay, going into the fact that Esau is the one in rulership right now, and he's the one that's what? He's the one that's perpetuating wickedness upon the face of the earth. Okay, so let's go back onto the book of Amos, and this is the 9th chapter, and we're still at the 8th verse. So it's Amos 9 and 8. It says, "The eyes of the Lord power upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face thereof. Right, saving utterly, I will not destroy the house of Jacob." Okay, now we need to examine what the scripture's saying here. He's saying here, look. All of this wickedness that's happening out here, all right, I'm recording it, I'm watching it, okay? And I'm going to destroy it from off the face of the earth, okay? But ultimately, this is going even deeper into talking about Babylon, okay? Because we know the scripture talks about how there was going to be a Babylon that existed right after the time of the Assyrians, and it was going to be a future Babylon, okay? A mystery Babylon, okay? Where with the people that was going to be living within those times were either going to be given the clues or the understanding to see that they're living in the time where this mystery Babylon was unveiled, or they was going to be blinded to that fact, and they was going to live all their lives, okay, in willingly ignorance, because all of the information is out there for you to decipher. You're living in a time where the new Babylonians are in rulership, the door of the Babylonians are in rulership, okay, all right, and then you was going to be destroyed within that kingdom, okay. So let's go back onto this. It says, "Hey, behold, the eyes of the Lord power upon the sinful kingdom, and I'll destroy it from off the face thereof, saving utterly, I will not destroy the house of Jacob, saith the Lord." So when the Most High has it to where Babylon is destroyed, which we know through the scriptures that Babylon is America, when the Most High has it to where that kingdom is destroyed, you're not going to have it to where the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, which are the Israelites, going to be destroyed within that land, okay? So let's go and see that within the scriptures, within the book of Revelations, the 18th chapter, okay? And I'll come back to Amos, the 9th chapter. But before I go to Amos, Revelations, the 18th chapter, let's go to Revelations, the 17th chapter, okay? Right, so the book of Revelations, the 17th chapter, and the first verse, okay? So Revelation 17 and 1 says, "And there came one of the seven angels, which had the seven vials, and talked with me, saying, Come hither, and I'll show you the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters." So there was going to be an entity, all right, a being, okay, right? And we know the scriptures talk about certain countries, certain places as pertaining to having beasts, okay, or as pertaining to what? As pertaining to, they might refer to a her or she, okay? Right, the door of Zion, that's referring to the Israel, okay? So as pertaining to this woman that sit up upon many waters, this was going to be a country, because we know the many waters represent a vast quantity of people, okay? So we know that this woman that's going to sit on the vast quantity of people was going to be a prominent country, okay, that was going to have resources coming from all over the place, control and influence going all over the place, okay, and she was going to commit, she was going to deal with these different nations in a way that was likened unto adultery. That's why she's known as what? As a great whore, okay, meaning all of her philosophies was going to be perpetuated onto these different countries, okay. She was going to rape, rob, murder all of these different countries, etc., etc. Okay, so Revelation is the 17th chapter and the first verse. It says, "And there came one of the angels which had the seven vials and talked with me, saying, Come thither, and I'll show you a lot of wind. Thank you very much. Okay. Sorted it out. Okay, so that should do for now. Okay. Okay, so back within the book of Revelations, the 17th chapter. Okay.
I'm going to be in that Mr. Smiley, sir. Sorry.
That's all right.
No worries.
Okay. Back within the book of Revelations, the 17th chapter. Okay, we'll read that from the top again from the first verse. It says, and there came one of the angels, right, one of the seven angels which had the seven vials, and talked to me, saying, come thither, and I'll show you the great judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters. Okay, second verse. With whom the nations of the earth have committed fornications with, and the inhabitants of the earth have made drunk with the wine of the wrath of fornication. So the doctrine that she pushes forth, okay, that's what's that dealing with. That's what that's dealing with. Dealing with governments, dealing with disorder, okay? All right, and when we're talking about destruction, well, Esau really the one that's perpetuated the destruction. He's the first destroyer, okay? Because when you go into the word destruction, it's actually dealing with the loss of structure, to destructure something. Okay, we're talking about the family structure that the Mosai implemented, that's spoken about within the scripture. Well, Esau has destructured that. Okay, we're talking about how a ruling body is supposed to be governed. Esau has destructured that. Okay, so when you're talking about destruction, well, Esau is the one that's destroyed everything upon the face of the earth. All right, and when you get into finding out within the scriptures, is that what? Is that when this particular group of people are in rulership, they was going to destructure the construct of life itself to the point, to the end where the very earth that you're living in has been completely destructured. So the Most High is going to have to destroy him from off the face of the earth. Okay? So back within the book of Revelations, the 17th chapter. Okay? And this is the second verse. It says, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornications with, and the earth has made drunken with the wine of her wrath of fornications. Okay, so he carried me away in the spirit, right? That rain come from? Should stop. Okay. Hopefully it's just spontaneous. Okay. I think it's just spontaneous. Okay, so second verse. Third verse of more. So he carried me away within the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet colored beast. So a scarlet or the color scarlet is the color red. Okay, so he saw a woman, okay, that sitteth upon many waters, a multitude all the people upon the face of the earth is likened unto the sea, okay, for number. Okay, so he saw a country, okay, represented as a woman, okay, sit upon many different countries, had all kind of wicked influence upon all of these different people, okay? And when he saw that, he also saw that in the vision that he had this woman sit upon a scarlet, or rather more red-colored beast, okay? Now, we're going to the book of Genesis, the 27th chapter, or rather more Genesis, the 25th chapter. We're finding out that there's two nations that was born unto Isaac, Jacob and Esau, right, or the Edomites and the Israelites, okay? And when Esau came out, he came out red, okay? And as a whole group of people, they was likened unto what? They was likened unto that color red, that's a synonymous thing with them. So when you have it to where they have this red, scarlet-colored beast, okay, and this woman sits upon her, you got to ask yourself, what is this talking about? Is this talking about a literal beast, okay, or is this talking about something more deeper? And we go into the book of Daniel, Daniel the 7th chapter or the 8th chapter, I forget which one off the top of my head, okay, I'm not going to try to find it now, but you're finding out that all of these different nations, these different empires that were set up before, in our aforetime, they was always likened unto beasts, okay? So when you have this red beast, boy, that's going to be alluding to Esau. Okay, and you got it to where there's a woman that has influence, and all of these different nations have committed fornications with her. That's going to be dealing with who? That's going to be dealing with America. So what country or what entity does America influence and sit upon? Okay, that's going to be NATO. So you got it to where NATO is that red colored beast, Esau's power structure, okay, with whom that beast goes throughout the different countries, these different nations, threshing, okay, destroying, okay, right, a destructuring. That's what this beast was there for, okay? And that woman was gonna say, look, we're gonna go over here, we can go over there, okay? And the whole thing of that, you can see that within the so-called geopolitical world, okay, to where if you go there, to where all of these different countries out there within Syria, they're complaining and they're being destroyed by who? By NATO and America. You got it to where you got a thing out there within North Korea. They're saying what? They're saying that, who is it, North Korea, I always forget which one's which. Okay, but you got this thing out there, skirmish within Korea right now, okay, which really stemmed from World War II, and you had it to where the old Soviet Union wanted influence and protection along with China, okay, from existential forces, which was America, and you had that division start up between South Korea and North Korea, because you had it to where one was associated with Japan, right, with which Japan is associated with what? With NATO and America, and you had it to where the other side was associated with who? Was associated with China, okay? So you had it to where the Chinese side of things wanted to what? They wanted to say, look, this is gonna be the buffer zone, okay? We ain't gonna have it to where all of the American influence is gonna come right onto our doorstep. So they was gonna control that particular region and have influence in that particular region, okay? And you had it to where the Japanese side, they went over there. So that whole skirmish is a whole thing of territory, okay? But that all comes off of what the scripture's saying, or where if you was gonna have a woman, America, sitting up on this beast, and they were gonna control this beast, which is NATO saying, we're gonna go over here, we're gonna go over there, okay? And when we go over there, we're gonna take all the resources there, okay? We're gonna control all the resources over there, because that's what you do when you're in dominion. That's what you do when you're in rulership. Because the thing of a ruler is to do what? Is to control resources, okay? That's why it's called a kingdom, right? A domicile of the kings, okay? So let's go back onto the book of Revelations, the 17th chapter, and this is the third verse. It says, so he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit up on a scarlet colored beast. So we deciphered that now, all right? With names full of blasphemy, having 7 heads and 10 horns, okay? Talking about the 10 common economic markets of Esau, all right? So it says there, right, arrayed in purple and scarlet color, decked with gold and precious stones, having a golden cup in her hand full of abominations of fornication. So now we've seen that. Now let's go to the book of Revelations, the 18th chapter. Because tying back onto the first precept that I pulled out within the book of Amos, the 9th chapter, we're getting into finding out that when Babylon is destroyed, or this wicked kingdom, this society, okay, that the Most High has a discrepancy against, we find out within the scriptures that the Lord said, look, he's not going to utterly destroy the house of Jacob. So to fortify that point, we're going to go to the book of Revelations, the 18th chapter, and see what the scriptures say as pertaining to the destruction of Babylon, okay, and what it says as pertaining to the people of the Most High, okay? So this is the book of Revelations, the 18th chapter, and the first verse, and it says, and these things I saw, and that's Brother Moy says, after these things I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lit with his glory, okay? And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying,